Hey everybody, it's Jordan with PTQ.com. It's Patch Tuesday, and it's been kind of an interesting month so far. A total of 55 exploits or CVEs got closed up, with four of them being critical. That's about half the total number of CVEs to be closed, and about one-third to one-quarter of the critical ones found. So on pure numbers, not that bad. The problem is, of those four critical, two of them are really, really bad. The first one, CVE-2021-28476. This is an exploit for Hyper-V, so if you don't have Hyper-V in your environment, don't worry about this one so much. But if you are using Hyper-V, it is rated a 9.9 out of 10 on the CVE scale. So just about, just short of the, you know, the apocalypse is how they rate that one. And what it does is it allows a VM host to send a bad IP, and the response that it gets back to that one, there's something that they can read in the memory, and they can run a lot of things against on that one. I read the description. It was, I mean, it's rated as a complex one to implement, and it was, I couldn't even read it and really understand it. But a 9.9 means that someone knows what they're doing, they're going to do some bad things. So that's definitely one to get patched. The other one is a 9.8 out of 10, and that is CVE-2021-31166. This one is on the HTTP protocol stack, and it requires no user interaction and can be done. It's a remote executable, which means, in my mind, that's a warmable bug. They don't say that specifically with the new system. They really removed a lot of the information they give you, and the description was blank on this one. But all you have to know is low complexity, uses the HTTP protocol stack, requires no user interaction. That usually means warmable and very, very dangerous. So this is one definitely we want to get patched. I'm not sure why that one's rated lower than the Hyper-V one, but definitely that's one you want to get in your system as soon as possible. And outside of just the Windows ones, there's an Adobe patch out there that with the Adobe Reader, the patch that came out today fixes this one, but this one is known in the wild, and it allows users to execute malicious code in the user context. So if your users don't have admin rights, they can't run it as an admin, but in that case, it's a good stepping point to other methods to get full control. If they do have admin rights, well, you just made it easy on them, I guess. So that's definitely one where that one's already being used in the wild. You want to get your Adobe patch as soon as possible. Those three make it a pretty bad month for it. So low numbers, but high critical issues on that one. So have your lab environment set up. Get those patched right away, whatever your time frame is. You then go through and update the rest of your system. Maybe on the Adobe one, you might want to consider breaking your time frame and getting that patched right away. But for PTQ.com, I'm Jordan.